revenue with great football experience. So far as football is concerned, every morning we're going to give you football in the next 30 minutes. So coming up, we're going to do spotlight. We have spotlight, that is, we take, can be a personality, a club or any stakeholder in football, someone who worth celebrating. Then we come to our discussion where we do foreign news, everything that is trending so far as football is concerned. Then we come to our local front, that everything that is happening around us, wherever you are. My name once again is Delali Frank Awute, and I welcome you to The Goal. Let's go for this quick break. When we return, we get into the show.
All girls all over the world, original King Julian on the caseman. I love how all the girls move their body. And when you move your body, you're gonna move it nice and sweet and sassy, alright? Woman, you're cute, and you don't need no makeup. Original cute body, makeup on model. Woman, you're cute, and you don't need no makeup. Original cute body, makeup on model. Woman, physically fit, physically fit, physically, physically, physically fit. Woman, physically fit, physically fit.
Thank you for staying with us. You're welcome once again to The Goal. So, we are going straight to our spotlights, but let me introduce my guest first. Entry.
I think now the brand has been, you know,
AM Boisiako. You are welcome, guy.
Thank you very much, boss.
And it's The Goal. How do you see?
You know, we promised viewers that we're going to bring them undiluted, you know, unblemished sports here on Pan African TV, and that is what we're delivering. We came your way with Russia 360, gave you up to speed updates of all the happenings in Russia, mm-hmm. as far as the World Cup is concerned, comprehensive report of all the happenings in Russia.
Exactly.
And here we are again. We promised you that sports has come to stay on Pan African TV. Early in the morning, we give you the juiciest sports news for you to, you know, spice
before
up
you
your
go,
day.
Before you do everything that is.
So that is what we're doing, and we wish that you'll be able to work with us through the times and get you updated with the happenings in the world of sports.
Yes. Thanks, Entry. That's, Entry has wrapped everything up for us. That is it. So today we have our spotlight, as usual. We have a spotlight that is a personality that we worth celebrating. And we have Luka Modric. But before you say something about Luka Modric, let's go watch this particular feature about Luka Modric. When we return, The Goal still continues.
Luka Modric, born on 9 September 1985, is a Croatian professional footballer who plays as a midfielder for Spanish club Real Madrid and is captain of the Croatian national team. He plays mainly as a central midfielder, but can also be deployed as an attacking midfielder or defensively and as a deep-lying playmaker. Modric is widely regarded as one of the finest midfielders of his generation and among the greatest Croatian footballers of all time. Able to blend traditional and trequartista playmaking effectively, he is known for his vision, precision in execution, and tactical strategy. Born in Zadar, Modric's childhood coincided with the 1990s Croatian War of Independence, which displaced his family. At age 16, he was signed by Dinamo Zagreb in 2002 after showing promise with his hometown's club youth team. He continued his development in Zagreb before spells on loan to Zrinjski Mostar and Inter Zaprešić. He made his debut for Dinamo in 2005 and won 3 consecutive league titles and domestic cups with them, being named the Pirova HNL Player of the Year in 2007. In 2008, he moved to Premier League club Tottenham Hotspur for a record-high transfer fee of £16.5 million, where he led Spurs to their first ever UEFA Champions League appearance in almost 50 years, reaching the quarterfinals of the 2010-2011 edition. After the 2011-2012 season, Modric joined Real Madrid for a €30 million transfer fee, where he became a key contributor under head coach Carlo Ancelotti and helped the team to win La Decima, being elected to the squad of the season. After Zinedine Zidane took over Madrid, Modric was critical to 3 consecutive Champions League titles from 2016 to 2018, each time being elected to the squad of the season. He would go on to win the La Liga Award for Best Midfielder in 2016 for the second time, and UEFA Club Football Award for Best Midfielder a year later. Modric made his international debut for Croatia against Argentina in March 2006 and scored his first international goal in a friendly match against Italy. Modric has anchored Croatia's second golden generation, where he has since participated in every tournament Croatia qualified for, including the 2008, 2012, and 2016 Euros, as well as the 2006, 2014, and 2018 FIFA World Cups. At Euro 2008, he was elected to the team of the tournament, becoming only the second Croatian to ever achieve this honor. In 2015, he became the first Croat to be included in the FIFA World 11, in which he was included once again in 2016 and 2017, as well as the UEFA Team of the Year in 2016 and 2017. Following group stage eliminations in the
Luka Modric, the Croat. Empty. Modric, in one word.
He's a beast of a midfielder.
Yeah.
You know. That is how we, yeah. A beast, let me put it that way, in quotes, as in football sense.
If you mention Xavi,
Iniesta, you know, yeah, of this current generation.
Yes, you need to mention Luka Modric.
Very well. I think that he's risen through the ranks as well. You know, he's seen it all from Dynamo Zagreb to Inter Milan, to
Tottenham
Hotspur to Real Madrid. I think he has grown to become one of the greatest midfielders the game has ever seen. He's a great player to talk about. I think it will take us days to, you know, be able to speak to such a player. And it's no surprise that he is our first spotlight on maiden edition of the goal. I think just in the tournament, he happens to be the golden ball winner.
Overall best player.
Yes. So credit to Luka Modric. I'm a Barca fan, but I even always say that Luka Modric is one of the best things that has happened to me.
He can win the
Ballon d'Or. As it stands now, I think there has been debate. The debate is ongoing, but I think that he has a chance in the sense that he's part of the team that has won the four Champions League, mm-hmm. and he's won four. He's been able to bring Croatia and unknown. They are known, let me say, a nation that many tip not to go as far as the World Cup is concerned. He's able to lead them as a skipper, spearheaded the team to that final, grand finale. Most of us thought he would have won to maybe put the icing on the cake, but he got to the final.
But that doesn't take anything from
the shine out of him. And he's competing. I think people are raising concerns as to somebody like Rafael Varane winning the same Champions League with Modric and Ronaldo, and also coming to win the World Cup itself. But defenders,
it will be a debate.
And what's the advantage to him? Quickly, the advantage for him is that Ronaldo has moved from Madrid to Juventus. Now, Luka Modric would have World Club Championship to play. Would also have Super Cup to play. So should he win that, it will come and credit him, and it will probably increase his chances of, you know, winning the Ballon d'Or.
Probably. Let's move on to our discussion proper. So we are starting with our Luka story. And what is happening in Ghana? Football is not that someone will say football. They are not playing football in Ghana. But Ghana Stars is playing tomorrow against Vita Club in the CAF competition. There are chances as they move forward, although they've not had in active football, one will say.
Yes, I think that it's tomorrow. We hope for the very best for the Adriana Stars guys. We hope for the very best, playing at home to Vita Club. Let's not forget, Vita Club is one of the best teams. He tops his league, I think, by 55 points or so. Mm-hmm. And as in the Congolese league, that team would be very, very difficult or cumbersome for Adriana Stars to be able to, you know, beat them. But yeah, and one thing that gets them not being able or make it their chances of winning the game very difficult would have to be the fact that here you are playing with somebody who has an active leg, as mm-hmm. compared to you that you don't even know the feet of your leg or where your leg stands as it mm-hmm. be now. So we want to see what would really happen, what should happen, what would happen tomorrow. Today is Tuesday, so tomorrow Wednesday, that would be the game. I think Peter Club stops the group there, and I think if I'm right, Raja Casablanca, Asec comes in, mm-hmm. Raja Casablanca.
Yeah. Let's look at their chances. Let's look at, they've changed coach. Kenichi comes in just some few days. He's playing his first match, and this is very competitive.
This is a crucial.
Is it going to cost them, or is just?
I think that you know, changing coaches definitely would influence the team, as we saw with the Spaniards mm-hmm. or the La Roja guys. You know, the Spanish guys. Changing coach, you know, cost them when they had a certain Lopetegui moving for Fernando Hierro, who they didn't ever expect to, you know, be put as a substantive coach to come and coach the Spanish national team. He came in and he could not really deliver. Most of us, you know, apportioning the blame to the changes, the tactical changes, or the big the changes in the bench where the coach left for Real Madrid. So that amounted to it, and I think that
The change in coach
would probably be an advantage or disadvantage. So it depends on how they are able to leverage on the opportunity or either make it
Should we judge Kenichi based on this match, or this just like what we did to Kwesi Appiah? If you qualify, fine. If you don't qualify, there's nothing wrong with it.
I really don't know the terms and conditions that, you know, it's incorporated into the contract of Kenichi.
But in your point as a sports analyst, should we judge him based on that, or just
that is what I'm saying, that I'll be prejudgmental if I should say that he should be sacked or whatever, because probably he went in and told them that I'll qualify you I'm assuming without admitting, as the lawyers will say. So that is what my standard. So either if that is the terms and conditions, fine. But if it is not so, then I think you should be given a chance to, you know, try other opportunities after, even if this doesn't succeed, which we don't pray for.
Okay. So, Adriana, what can Adriana do to beat Club Vita? Because they are playing home, and at least someone will say they have the home support.
Sure. When you're playing home, definitely you have 12 players. Your fans are the player number 12, and that would be another advantage to them. I think that it all isn't too well for them, but I would want them to go into the game with either a lose or draw mentality, not to go and lose. And so if they know that they can't really go in all out, and they know that they are quite deficient, or their defense is quite insipid, that they can't probably be able to, they should sit and break on the counter attack. That is the current style for you. If you know that you can't open up, sit back as the French normally do, and break on a counter attack. And all you need to do is make sure that your flanks are very, very, very sharp and very ferocious to, you know, search the ball in or get the ball crosses into the strikers to probably, you know, convert it into goal.
Yeah, Diana, they can't lose. They have no, because when they lose, they are out of the
tournament.
They have no chance. So that's entry tanks. That's local. Let's move foreign. Cristiano Ronaldo has been officially unveiled as Juventus player yesterday. We're going to have footages of that. But let's look at Cristiano Ronaldo, 33 years. He said something that most of the time, 33 years, they are going to. No, he said no disrespect to Qatar and China League, but someone said they are going for their pension pay. But look at him, 33 years, going for Juventus.
I think Ronaldo is a player that, you know, despite not being his fan, I think that he should be credited for keeping his form. He hardly goes, gets injured. I am told he has about 16 doctors that takes care of him. His health. Wherever he goes with those 16 doctors. So one for maybe a diet, one nutritionist, one for maybe his knee, one for I don't know his stomach. That tells you how serious a player he is. As he's 33, he looks more or less like somebody who is 25 years.
Yeah.
Let's not take that away from you. So Ronaldo is a player that I know that he can play more than that 4 years contract that he has signed. He's been able to move from grass to grease, from oblivion to stardom, way back coming to England, you know, to Spain. I think he has been a player that has promised, or he's been a very promising player. No wonder he's been able to win a Ballon d'Or for 5 good times and win the European Cup as well as with his national team. He has done a lot of things. Yeah.
And let's look at something. 33 years, he looks very active, but he said something at the press conference that he wished that he would come there at 23 years, but now he's 33. That means that he's a little bit worried when it comes to age difference.
I think this is where I would have to fuse in seven players that were signed from their clubs at a very old age, you know, more than 30 years. So Pele, Graciano Pele from Southampton, all of them count. But the first 7th person here would be Zlatan Ibrahimovic. At age 30, moved from Milan to PSG at a fee of £15.7 million. You have a certain Jeremy Mathieu of Barcelona. He moved from Valencia to Barcelona 2014 at a fee of £15.8 million. The 5th person is Claudio Makélélé, at a fee of £60 million from Madrid to Chelsea 2003. We have Claudio Bravo for a fee of, he was at 33, at a fee of €17 million from Barca to City 2016. Quickly, Samuel Eto'o was mistered at age 32.
Remember.
Moved from Inter to Andy Makarskara in Russia for a fee of €22 million.
But looking at all these changes, I think Cristiano Ronaldo's challenge is a little bit bigger.
So quickly, I would want to end here. I think Gabriel Batistuta comes next at age 30, €23.5 million, Fiorentina to Roma in 2000. And Diego Batistuta, that age 30, same, move from Genoa to Inter, 24.7 million euros. Mm-hmm. Then Ronaldo comes to break that record. He's being signed for 105 million euros, about three times that amount, quadruple of that amount. And that tells you that Ronaldo is really a player that you can't underestimate him at his 33. He's a player that nobody can take anything away from him. He's touted as one of the best of all time. I don't argue with that. It will be a debate here. So, Ronaldo, I don't know what you wanted to say me, but Ronaldo has been a player that football is happy to see.
But looking at these changes and this change of don't you think it's a bigger challenge for Ronaldo as we wrap
sure,
up?
Sure, it would be a big challenge for him, but the issue is he has nothing to lose. He's won it all that he wants to win, apart from the World Cup that he's not been able to had a glimpse of it personally. And so if he should not even be able to, you know, do much exploit with Juventus, the old ladies, I think nobody would really condemn him. But we hope to see. The challenge now is that he's a player that is known to move from countries to countries and is able to thrive. And so we expect him to probably, you know, do my wonders with Juventus, especially when he wins the league. It's normal.
Yeah.
Juventus with the league, but Champions League is what we hope.
Because he says he has a hope of winning the Ballon d'Or once again, and he's wishing to do it with Juventus. Do you see that's possible?
It can be. He's still in shape, and he's still playing on top of his game, breaking records here and there. So I think that is.
And let's wrap up with the benefits that Juventus has paying this amount of money are going to get from Cristiano Ronaldo, apart from social media hypes and presence that they are getting, and to the entire Serie A league itself.
Yes, I think that quickly. I think Juventus had about 6 million. How do you call it? People following them.
Yes.
Is it Twitter or Instagram or one of them? Yeah. When Ronaldo went, the number has surged to an all-time like. The number is
increasing. Yes.
Ronaldo himself has about 74.5 million followers.
Nice. Entire community. More than Croatia.
I think that the advantage of it, commercial-wise, being somebody, if I want to speak from the marketing point of view, Jeep, who sponsors how do you call it, Juventus, they have their sponsors for Juventus. Annually, they have about 20 million euros from exposure. They pump in 20 million into Juventus to sponsor them. Now, as part of the value for money exchange, they are going to get about 120 million euros for exposure. That is the kind of thing that we are going to see. That is what is at stake. And Juventus will never, you know, lose. They will come back and reap all their profits in no time. From JCs to other issues.
Yeah, because JC is, I've been told that the JC sells each day. It's each per minute one JC is sold.
Surely.
And that is right.
It wouldn't be any wonder.
Let's wrap up. Cristiano Ronaldo's performance, your expectation on him and Adriana Stars too, let's wrap up.
I think I see a draw for Adriana Stars. It would be hard for me to see them. I'll be happy if they should win, but I see a draw. Ronaldo, we wish him the very best. I think he'll be able to rejuvenate the days or the days of the Italians here that we knew it to be. He'll bring them from oblivion to stardom of this current football league. So kudos to Ronaldo. We wish him all the best.
All right. Kudos to Ronaldo. Pressure on Ronaldo. Thanks, Entry, for coming. And this is where you are going to bring the maiden edition of The Goal on Pan-African Television. My name is Uzua Esdelali Frank Aute. Thanks for being with us. As I always been saying, support the team with all your hearts. But don't forget to support you. Thanks to our producers, everybody who has been with us. Tomorrow, we come again your way with another exciting edition. The newspaper review segment continues.